here for, and we just find it such a wonderful privilege. You know, for me it's something wonderful. I travel around the diocese, which is very far-flung and very rural. It's 500 meters, kilometers from east to west. I'm 400 kilometers from north to south. And often I'll be way out in some rural village, and there the people will say, that is the mission house where Father so-and-so from England lived for 30 years. Amazing sacrificial ministry by which people brought the gospel to us. And so it's something very special that we can come from Africa and bring the good news back to you. Jesus told parables. And I've got a very simple definition of what a parable is. A parable is a story that makes us think. That's what it is. It's a story that makes us think. And so often the parables are open-ended because we have to write the ending. And how the parable turns out depends very much on how we think about it and how we choose to respond to it. And so the invitation when we hear one of Jesus' parables is to put ourselves into the story, to put ourselves into the shoes of the characters and say, if I am the younger brother, how do I respond? If I'm the older brother in this parable, how do I respond? And what does the Father say to me? And that's partly how I come to write songs. I've been writing songs for almost as long as I can remember. And I find writing songs is a way in which I can get into a parable or a passage of scripture and meditate on it and think about it and then express it. So most of the talks this week, I'll sing a song, one or another song. This evening there are two, because I tried for many years to write a song about this amazing parable, and I found I couldn't. Until I put myself into the shoes of the younger son, and then a song came out, which is the song of the younger son. And then I put myself into the shoes of the older brother, and the song came out, which is the older brother's song, and I'll share that a little bit later. So, listen to this parable.
The scraps they feed the pigs. No.
your sons and daughters are here. Or for that matter, how many younger sons and daughters are out there in the Purley community just waiting to be invited to get to know the love of God the Father. We've been given so much. God has given you, if you're a younger son or daughter, an education probably, material things, gifts and talents, all sorts of spiritual blessings. But as soon as we begin to focus on me, instead of doing God's will, it all goes to waste. So we find ourselves in this world accumulating more and more things and losing out more and more on relationships with God, with our family, and with our friends. This week is an opportunity, if you are a younger son or daughter, or if you know someone who is in the shoes of a younger son or daughter, to come back, to return to this embrace, this generous love of God the Father. And then we have the older son. Now, I regret that I have to say, having been a bishop for 17 years and a priest for, I don't know, something like 30, I'm probably more like the older brother than the younger one. And I'm not sure which one is worse in the parable. So let me sing you the older son's song. And put yourself for a moment in the shoes of that older brother as his younger brother takes all the stuff and takes off to have fun and to live for himself.
Selfish little boy, he makes me mad.
to nurture our relationship with God our Father through prayer, through reading the scriptures, through offering ourselves in ministry and service. Oh no, I could never do that. But we've been given everything, and there's so much joy awaiting us if we will simply offer ourselves to God. It says in the Eucharistic prayer, it is our duty and joy always and everywhere to give thanks. But if we're like older brothers, it becomes more and more duty and less joy. And if you're like that, God, I believe, would like to rekindle the joy in your life at the moment. Maybe I can tell you a story. My wife Sarah died 7 years ago after a long battle with brain cancer. She had a dreadful brain tumor, 3 lots of surgery, 100 of chemotherapy, 100 of other alternative therapies, small side effects like having meningitis and all sorts of things on the way. And during that time, our joy, although God was amazing, I realized that I lost the ability really just to be uninhibited and full of joy. And in the last month or 6 weeks, God has begun to give that back to me because I've met an amazing person, and this is exciting. And it's like falling in love all over again. You feel that lightness, you know. I would wake up 6 months ago thinking, oh, another day. Older brother thought. Now I wake up and think, there's someone who loves me. And that's what it's like. God wants to rekindle that love of Him, that excitement of getting to know the living God deeper and deeper and deeper. So whether you are an older brother or a younger brother, God has something for you during this week. And the way back, four words that begin with R. The first one is recognize. Recognize that you have a need for God to draw closer to you and for you to draw closer to God. The younger and older brother had lost their connection. Maybe you've lost your connection, and this week is an opportunity to recognize that and say, I need to get back to my first love. Secondly, repent. Repent just means turn around. It just means do something to make it right again. One of the things you can do is chat to one of the members of the team. It's tremendous when a team comes from outside, because you can share things with them and then they'll go away, and no one else in the community will have to know what you've talked about. And they are available anytime to listen to you and to pray with you. Recognize, repent. The third R is return. Do something practical to offer yourself back to God. Offer yourself in some way to serve Him. Make a commitment in some way to draw closer to Him. Maybe to get up 10 minutes earlier and spend that time in prayer. And the fourth R is receive. Receive God's blessing. This week is an opportunity to receive from God. Don't let it pass you by. So, an invitation. The loving Father is saying, no matter who you are, an older brother, younger brother or sister, some kind of mixture of the two, come to me. I'm waiting. I love you. I want to draw you into my arms. So let's spend a moment in silence as we think about this.